When I was in the National Assembly, I proved by two motions on the floor that what is weekly passed in the National, in the Federal Executive Council is fraud. When I moved the motion on the airport runway, the construction of the second airport runway in Abuja, that was awarded at 64 billion. And I went around six airports abroad and even local airports in Nigeria. And I proved that we wanted to construct a 3.8 kilometer runway. I went to Heathrow with a four Heathrow Terminal 5 airport with 4.0 kilometer with four lanes constructed for 11 billion. We are trying to construct a 3.8 with two runways for 64 billion. I said no. That motion succeeded. The president set up a committee and the project was reduced to 49 billion. I came back to the floor. I said that 49 billion is still a rape because what Julius Berger proposed was 8 billion. The president was untwisted, eventually the contract was cancelled. That contract passed through due process. That contract passed through the Federal Executive Council.
Tortoise.
What happened? The tortoise. So I want to say, the transition road project that is ongoing between Kubwa and Airport Road was awarded at 257 billion. It passed through due process, it passed through the presidency. I raised that motion on the floor of the House. A committee was set up, and disgracefully, the MD of Julius Berger came and said it's typographical error. I'm sure most of you saw that. He said it's typographical error. Today, 100 billion have been saved as a result of that motion on that road. So you cannot begin to imagine the magnitude and intensity of corruption that we are going through in this country. I tell you, we have done a research and we are coming up with it. 60% of our national budget is lost to corruption and wastage. We must do something. If you refuse to do something, something will do you. Last week, we picketed the Ministry of Finance, accusing the minister, why should the Minister of Finance, coordinating Minister for the Economy, no, that term is not known to law. It's not known to law, it's alien to Nigerian law. Awarded and paid Pinnacle Construction Company 2.7 billion naira. And when I was looking at the list as released by Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala, there are 25 companies after the abracadabra with IQ Bogodi's committee. I was looking at the name and I saw number 22 on the 25 list, from the 25 list. Pinnacle Construction Company. That agitated me. Construction company lifting oil. So I called my director of legal in the anti-corruption network. And we went to CAC only to find out that Pinnacle Construction Company is not registered with Corporate Affairs Commission. That is the country you are in. The magnitude and intensity of corruption is gone beyond our thinking. JP Morgan, there's a secret account now in JP Morgan. Till this moment, 3 months after, they are yet to tell us who opened that account, despite the fact that the law and the constitution is clear that all revenues, all monies, must be paid into the consolidated account of the federal government. They opened a secret account and they are using it to fund their elections. And you are still sitting there enjoying AC and looking good. I will not be labeling you with unnecessary commentaries, rhetorics, or stories. This I'm being accused from suffering from verbal diarrhea. But I want to tell you that Nigeria as a country is in the emergency ward. And if we don't, if we allow these people to continue to photocopy the thesis of the tortoise, then Nigeria will move to intensive care units.
Are we not?
It lies, the whole thing is between you and I. Pastor Bakary would have failed. Erufai would have failed. The Odumakins would have failed. Melaye would have failed. General Muhammadu Buhari would have failed if we refuse to organize another Occupy Nigeria before the end of this year.
That's my man.
In an unjust society,
silence
is a crime. We must take back Nigeria from these criminals. These financial cankerworms and economic scavengers, you must recover Nigeria from them. Power truly belongs to the people. The voice of the people is the voice of God. We have to. It's not a matter of choice. These leaders, the progressive in this country, must sit and decide. Martin Luther King said on 11th November 1964, I have a dream that one day in the heights of Georgia, he said the sons and daughters of slave owners will sit with sons and daughters of slaves to decide the future of America. Today, a black man is in the White House. So, the rich and the poor, the haves and the have-nots, the oppressed and the oppressors, these leaders must sit on the table to decide the future of this country. If we continue to hold seminars like this, we continue to blackberry, we continue to tweet, we will come back next year again and have the third version of this same Nigeria project. But I want to say, these leaders here must wake up from their slumbers. You, the followers, must wake up from your slumber. Together, we will take Nigeria to a right place. Anita Matima, Ikoria.